Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because this tea is what? Piping hot. Hey, you guys. So don't forget, for all your tea sipping needs, make sure you go on to lovelytea.net or amazon.com/shops/lovelytea. Thank you guys so much for the support and stay tuned for the video. Hey, you guys. I hope you guys are doing good today. So I want to come on here and talk about the whole Chris Brown situation, okay? So if you guys don't know, once again, Chris Brown is going through it. So what's going down is that basically this morning it was announced he's number one trending all over social media. And they have announced that Chris Brown has been arrested in Paris for drugs and rape allegations, okay? So this is what TMZ reported at 5 o'clock this morning. So what they're saying happened is this. Chris Brown and two of his team members were arrested by French police after a woman claimed that she was raped by the singer in the hotel room. The French authorities confirmed with TMZ that Chris Brown has been detained and is in custody for alleged aggravated rape and narcotics offense. The authorities went by to say that he's being processed, which is the French version of being arrested and booked. The woman said that she met Chris Brown overnight between January 15th and 16th at Club Le Crystal, then headed back to the Mandarin Oriental Hotel with the singer, where she claims to have been raped. The investigators now have 2 days to decide to file preliminary charges or let Chris Brown go. Chris Brown was spotted at another club in Paris Saturday night, just 3 days after the alleged rape, with Amika Harris, a woman that he's reportedly dating. The woman, they're calling her Karima, she's a 24-year-old model. She told a magazine that she met Chris Brown at the Mandarin Hotel in Paris on January 15th around 10:30 p.m., then went to a nightclub. Karima told them around 4 o'clock in the morning, Brown and his crew wanted to return to the hotel. She says she was tired, but they convinced her to go back to the Mandarin with a group of people. She says once inside his suite, she went to the bathroom. So then she then goes on to say that Brown followed her and catches me by the right arm. He makes me enter a sort of a dressing room. He closed the door and it lasted between 25 and 30 minutes. She described the alleged rape as brutal and violent. She says she was then abused by one of Brown's friends and bodyguard. Karima also stated she went to the cops 2 days later, adding that she was scared, but ultimately decided that she did not want Brown to be able to do the same thing to other girls. Someone connected to Brown tells us that the singer was never alone with the alleged victim and says Chris's girlfriend, Amika Harris, was in the hotel room the whole time. He says there were more than 20 people in the room hanging out and listening to music. Brown was playing on his iPhone. We've reached out to Brown's U.S. attorney for response, but so far no word back. Now, what's disturbing about this situation is, if you guys remember the whole situation with Chris Brown and Rihanna that happened several years ago, he pled guilty to that felony. But besides the Rihanna situation, Chris Brown was sued back in May of this year by a woman who claimed that she was raped at a party at the singer's home. The woman claimed that Chris Brown supplied party attendees with Molly, cocaine, and weed, and that one of his friends And that it was one of his friends who raped her. The LAPD investigated the woman's claim after she filed a report, but could not determine if the sex was forced or consensual, and that lawsuit is still ongoing. So there's a lot of crazy stuff right now, you know, attached to Chris Brown's name. And so T.I. pointed out a really good point, and I'm no fan of T.I., but T.I. took to social media, and this is what he posted just a little bit ago. Basically, if you guys don't know, Chris Brown signed a new deal and he became the youngest artist to own his master recordings. So T.I. says, first this, then rape allegations. Hashtag critical thinking. So definitely people's tin hats are definitely tingling. Okay. My thing is this. A lot of things bother me with this case. Okay. One thing, it just seems that Chris Brown cannot just seem to keep his ass out of trouble. It seems like trouble, for whatever reason, just follows this man. It's just always around him. And at this point, it's not even like just normal drama. I believe it's his vibrational frequency. I believe that there's something negative around him that's constantly attracting this type of shit to him. Because like I said, he's being sued right now for an alleged rape allegation that took place at his home in May of this year. And now he goes to Paris, and now this woman is alleging that, you know, Chris Brown raped her. And it might be a situation where, you know, the powers that be are trying to take him down because he's owning his master recordings. Because as we all know, once people own their masters, all of a sudden they wind up dead or in jail or, you know, made to look crazy. Look what happened to Prince and Michael Jackson. So, you know, I don't know. But one thing I will say is that Chris Brown is easy prey. He has money. He has a history of violence against women. So this could definitely be a quick cash grab for this so-called victim. But again, I have to put the onus on some of these guys. We have this entire Me Too situation going on, where every time you turn around, somebody's hollering out rape, abuse, Me Too. You know what I'm saying? Time's up. We're living in a different world. This is not the music industry. This is not the entertainment industry of yesteryear, okay? There's movements going on. There's people looking to come up. You know what I'm saying? I did a whole video yesterday on the whole R. Kelly situation. Look at how all those so-called victims are now, you know, writing books and going on media presses. So there's a lot of people who have disingenuous intentions, and they're literally willing to do whatever to come up. And these celebrities need to be aware of that. Every female you run across, every female you see in the club, does not mean you have to take her to the bedroom. Your intentions might just be to, you know, bust a quick nut. Her intentions might be solely to trap you or get you in trouble or, you know, holler out rape allegations. So this is why a lot of these men need to be really careful when they're out here trying to mess with these women, including T.I. You know, he's another one who's out here who can't keep his dick in his pants, who has a wife and he's always cheating on her. He could very well end up in the same situation. So I hope it wakes a lot of these guys up. At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? You don't know these women any more than they know you. So why are you bringing strangers that you don't know into your hotel room, into your vicinity? Because again, you don't know these people's true intentions. So people need to really watch the things that they're doing and the moves that they're making, okay? So this entire situation is very, very disturbing. The only thing we can do is just sit and watch and see how this plays out.
Chris Brown detained in Paris on suspicions of rape and alleged drug-related offenses. Things are at a standstill for the American singer. According to CBS News, French police officials say Chris and two other people are in custody in Paris after a 24-year-old woman filed a rape complaint. Reports claim his bodyguard is one of the others being detained. Before the incident, Chris was spotted stepping out for Paris Fashion Week events. The singer's camp has yet to respond to these news reports. Well, guys, this isn't the first time the pop stars had a run-in with the law. Chris has had a history of legal troubles stemming back a decade. Brown was convicted for the 2009 assault on his then-girlfriend Rihanna. He completed his probation back in 2015. Now, in 2013, he was charged with a misdemeanor assault and ordered to check into rehab after striking a man outside a Washington, D.C. hotel. As a result, he spent 2.5 months in custody. ET caught up with Chris after he faced jail time, where he said he had a very humbling experience. Take a look.
I think jail was all I needed, man. Honestly, I'll be honest, man. Being in there, you don't want to ever go back. I don't think anybody that gives you the story, the tough guys, it's like, yeah, man, I can go to jail. I ain't tripping. They're lying to you. They are lying to you. But I would just say that was all I needed, man. I think sometimes some of us need a wake-up call. I think that was my big one, so I'm good.
They wanted to villainize you more than give you a second chance. Absolutely. So what in you convinced yourself that you could get a second chance?
My faith, man. I think ultimately just me believing in the talents I've been given and gifted, you know, believing in my higher power and just really being looking like, okay, let's do this, man. You know, I think the underdog is something I've been used to being, you know. And I always having to prove myself, whether it having to be me as a man, me as an artist, me as a performer.
The Grammy winner's time staying out of trouble was short-lived. In 2016, Brown was arrested at his Los Angeles home for an alleged assault with a deadly weapon after former beauty queen Bailey Curran called 911 outside his house asking for help. Last year, he was arrested in Florida after a concert over an outstanding warrant for felony battery. I'm So if these accusations are true, it's really unfortunate because Brown appeared to be making a big comeback in his career. He's always seemed to be a really great dad with royalty, and the R&B singer dropped new music. He's been breaking music chart records. Just a lot has been going on. And if you've been online, his undecided dance challenge went viral. Now, just one day before reportedly being detained, the 29-year-old shared this snap from the studio captioned, "Dance rehearsal at Dancer Boy Smith got me working in Paris."
All right, so as I was recording this video, there was an update that broke through. So TMZ is now reporting as of 2 o'clock this afternoon, the French prosecutors tell TMZ that Chris Brown is free to leave France. He was released on his own recognizant without bail. They also stated, we've confirmed that Brown and the two other men who were detained have been released. The prosecutor's office tells TMZ that the investigations, which are not closed at this stage, will continue under the authority of the Paris prosecutor's office. On top of that, Chris Brown also took to Instagram and he wrote this. He said, for my daughter, my family, this is so disrespectful and against my character and morals. Then he wrote, this bitch lying. So this entire situation is getting crazier and crazier. Anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire crazy situation. Once again, concerning Chris Brown being arrested and charged with drug and rape allegations. Let me know your thoughts. All right, deuces. Hey, you guys, it's your girl T, and I hope you really enjoyed that video. If you want to know more about my look of the day, or if you want a way to contact me concerning advertisement and sponsorship deals, definitely feel free to click my description box. There's plenty of information in there. Please stay tuned for the next video. Talk to y'all later.